Thank you for watching our video. Please subscribe to our channel, click on the bell, like and comment. Thank you very much.
What is prophecy? Joel 2:28. I want to say that in this year, please lower the every sound and I'm coming to prophesy. The spirit in me is about to work.
Prophesy.
The spirit of me is about to work. This year, I am not talking to the nation of Ghana. I am not talking to the people of Ghana. Because of the repressive systems going on in Ghana. I'm not talking to the topographical, geographical land called Ghana. I am not talking to the people of Ghana. I am not prophesying to the people of Ghana or the nation of Ghana. I am prophesying to a nation called Umofia. I am prophesying to the people of Umofia. And as I'm about to prophesy,
the prophetic titan, the seer.
As I'm about to prophesy, I am talking as a religious leader. Whereby a spirit has entered me. Whereby a divine reality has entered me. That I don't even know what I'm saying. So, as you are watching and listening to me, if you know that you don't believe that God has called me, you have all the freedom, liberties available to you. To off your radio, to off your TV, to turn off what you are watching.
If
you give me the space to prophesy, and the prophecies are negative prophecies, my Bible tells me that the Lord reveals to redeem. So if it's a negative prophecy, if it's about dead prophecies, my God is able to deliver you. So the prophecy is not coming to cause fear. The prophecy is coming to redeem you.
My papa.
And if you allow me to prophesy, that means that I have your rights and I have your reputation.
Yes,
but before I go to the prophecies of 2022, I want to pass a few comments. I hear a lot of people say that let's gang the prophets. Nobody can gang the prophet. The president cannot gang the prophet. Nobody can gang the prophet. No state institution can gang the prophet. The prophetic was and is and forever.
Professor,
my father,
do the work.
The Bible says,
Professor.
Listen, the Bible says,
trust them, say
1 Thessalonians 5:20. Do not despise prophecies. Hosea 12:13. He said, by the hand of the prophet Israel was delivered.
And what if was so yet Israel for?
And by the hand of the prophet Israel was sustained.
And if was so, you cry Israel.
Joel 2:28. said, I'll pour my spirit upon all flesh. And the sons and daughters shall prophesy. And the greater part of prophecy is a dream. What is a dream? It is an image. It is an idea. It is sensations. It is emotions. That happens to us when we are asleep. And nobody, since the time of Adam to now, can give material evidence of his or her dream. So these prophecies I'm about to give, it is spiritual. And I had all of it whilst I was sleeping. In my sleep, I had a vision. What is a vision? It is a supernatural experience that reveals an encounter between divinity and humanity. Just as we cannot take the fetish priest to court because we believe that the fetish priest is possessed and is being manifested through a spirit. So is every prophet, and so is Prophet Naidogezi now. I am possessed.
Professor.
I am possessed. A spirit has entered me. Whatever I say, I don't know what I'm saying. Just had the fetish priest. Let's go to prophecy 2021. Then I'm coming to prophesy to the nation of Umofia.
Yes,
media, let's go. Listen to prophecy.
1 Thessalonians 5:20. Do not despise prophecies. The year 2021 has been an exciting year, despite all it came with. In all this, we say this far by grace, and all glory goes to Yehovah. At the Grace Sanctuary, the prophetic titan was inspired by God, and the following prophecies were uttered for both the national and international front with precision. These and many more were some of the prophecies for the year 2021. International prophecies.
This is prophetic prophecy for the nation Guinea.
Guinea.
It saw political instability.
So
the powers in Guinea, if you don't pray, there will be political instability in Guinea.
There
is going to be an insurgent. That will attack. So that is it.
Guinea.
The current president of Besa Winnie.
The current president
of Winnie. We are in Tokwa Bebaho. Guinea, Colandi, Miho Colandi, or whatever. Omom Empire.
West Africa Supreme. I saw military. I saw something like coup in one of the. I have seen the country, but I won't say in one of the countries. Praise God.
Not in his usual presidential attire. On this mobile phone video, the 83-year-old president appeared.
1 Thessalonians 5:20. Do not despise prophecies. The year 2021 has been an exciting year, despite all it came with. In all this, we say this far by grace, and all glory goes to Yehovah. At the Grace Sanctuary, the prophetic titan was inspired by God, and the following prophecies were uttered for both the national and international front with precision. These and many more were some of the prophecies for the year 2021. International prophecy.
This is prophetic prophecy for the
international prophecy.
This is prophetic prophecy for the nation Guinea.
Guinea.
It saw political instability.
So
the powers in Guinea, if you don't pray, there will be political instability in Guinea.
There
is going to be an insurgent. That will attack. So that is it.
Guinea.
The current president of Besa Winnie.
The current president of
Winnie. We are in Tokwa Bebaho. Guinea. Colandi, Miho Colandi, or whatever. Omom Empire.
West Africa Supreme. I saw military. I saw something like coup in one of the. I have seen the country, but I won't say in one of the countries. Praise God.
not in his usual presidential attire. On this mobile phone video, the 83-year-old president appears disheveled. He's being detained by the country's special forces. Men meant to protect him now hold him in custody. There were celebrations in some neighborhoods of the capital. This mobile phone video, the 83-year-old president appears disheveled. He's being detained by the country's special forces. Men meant to protect him now hold him in custody. Streets. Coup leaders have removed regional governors and replaced them with military commanders. All former ministers and government officials are expected to gather at 11 a.m. at the People's Palace. The coup leaders say any defiance will be treated as an act of rebellion.
Prophecy number 7.
Come to so and so.
A famous man of God or person.
Founder of the Synagogue Church of All Nations, TB Joshua, has died. His death has been confirmed by his church. The preacher died last night at a Lagos hospital. He was 57 years old.
My South Africa,
one of the icons is about to die. There is one of the icons that will go very soon.
Welcome to the program. We begin with breaking news coming out of South Africa, where the Nobel Peace Prize winner, Archbishop Desmond Tutu, has died. Appointed the first black Archbishop of Cape Town, Tutu rose to prominence in the 1980s as a vocal opponent of apartheid. He was 90 years old. Fumida, along with Nelson Mandela, he really was South Africa's moral compass through very dark times.
National Prophecy.
Listen to prophecy number 12. I saw a creeping creature coming out of the sea of Ghana and Nigeria. With its little babies crying in Ghana.
Wellington Booth.
No, Pastor Wellington Booth.
Let the family members, let them pray for him.
Because
I am seeing him in prison.
Me who do
prophecy number 5.
Wellington Booth. No, Pastor Wellington Booth.
I saw crisis. Let them pray
me
for
me
him.
I saw crisis.
In the northern part of Nigeria. Prophecy number 6. I saw a woman leading the world. And this woman I'm seeing her in America. I saw Harris in her name. Let's pray for her. Prophecy number 7. I saw the former president of America. Donald Trump. Coming back into active politics. Prophecy number 8. I saw and the Lord said. We should pray for the now president of America, his health. Why am I seeing Russia crying? Prophecy number 9. I saw a heavy cloud. Cloud of darkness. Covering the head of state of Umofia. Let's take this prophecy very seriously. I saw a cloud of darkness. Covering the head of state of Umofia. And I saw that the deputy is using mediums. To provoke for the quick passing away of the head of state. And I saw in the realm of the spirit that the shoe of the big man is being worn by the deputy. I saw in a nation called Umofia that something that has ever happened there is about to reoccur again.
an external explosive attack. There is a cloud of external combined internal attack on the nation and the people of Umufia. Let's pray. Let's pray. Let the security watch out. In the year 2022, I saw a lot of suicide. I saw suicidal cases being increased. Let's pray. Let's pray. Let's pray. I saw again the Lord carry my spirit. And I saw that the milk of cows were dry. I saw green leaves becoming dry. I saw mothers wail and cry. I saw fathers and men gnashing their teeth. I saw people in despair. I saw again, like I mentioned last year, a repeat of 1983. 2022 is going to be a very difficult year. I saw mothers cry. I saw fathers wailing and gnashing their teeth. Let's all sit up. Let's tighten our seats. The year is going to be a difficult year. But the Lord will see those who love him, who walk in his standard very well. The Lord will preserve them and keep them. The next prophecy. The hand of the Lord rested upon me and carried me into the election of 2024 or
2025.
In the nation called Umufia. And the Lord told me to tell them. Tell the CND people. They should forget about Asante region. They should focus more on the northern region. Because the election will be determined by these two regions. I saw the flag of green, red, and black. Taking dominance. But let them focus. More, let the CND people focus more on the northern region. Again, the Lord opened my eyes and carried me into the realm of the spirit. And when the Lord carried me there, the Lord said, I shall see. And the Lord said, if we don't wake up, and if the CND people don't wake up in Umufia, they will use system and the EC and NIA to twist the agenda and the will of the people. So let the CND people, let them be more vigilant. Let them be more vigilant. Let them be more vigilant. The Lord opened my eyes again. I saw in the year
2022,
barren woman taking seed.
I saw
the Lord said, you honor more women.
And I said,
and anybody who is barren any aspect of their life, the Lord said is going to give them fruitfulness and productivity. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The next prophecy. The Lord carried my spirit to a place. And I saw a place, and I saw the flag of Umufia. And there was red, there was gold in the flag. And the Lord carried my spirit to the assembly of the people. And when I got to the assembly of the people, it was closer to a stadium. The Lord said, I should tell the minority and the leadership of the minority that there is a conscious effort to reduce them. So they should go check how they go about their things to avoid a by-election. Let me tell you that there's going to be a by-election. in the nation of Umofia. It is deliberate, but it is avoidable. The Lord again carried my spirit to the people's assembly. And I saw in Umofia a man that is sitting in the middle of the chair. And there was a red flag, something like red thing that had tied the chair. And I saw that the people were so sad. I don't know. Let's pray for the center man in Umofia. Using another card, transferring the card. And they wanted to twist and do things. So let everybody be vigilant and watchful. The next prophecies. The Lord carried my spirit again. And I entered into Umofia. I entered to a session of Umofia. And I saw an entity. And on the forehead of the entity, I saw a name written like Tremantin. I saw a golden key that was taken away from him. And the Lord said, this is not his will. Sir, if you can quicken yourself as Esau was told, what is due you will not be given to another. I repeat that prophecy again. The Lord carried my spirit to Umofia. A part of Umofia, I saw an entity. And on the forehead of the entity, I saw Tremantin. And the Lord said, look at that, and I saw. And I saw an effort being made to take a golden key that belongs to him. And on the key, I saw that there were colors on the golden key. But predominantly, I saw something like blue. And I saw that it was being taken away from him. Then the Lord said, this is not my will. But said, just as Esau was told, if you can quicken yourself, you will be given what is due. Let's check your heart. Let's pray for your heart. The next prophet, I saw university, close down universities. I saw a lot of strikes. I saw union strikes. From February, January, there's going to be a lot. This year is going to experience unprecedented strikes in the history of Umofia. The next prophecy. A female running mate in one of the West Africa states.
As a West African man, no. As a female, be our running mate.
Female.
Aba.
Running mate.
Are you running mate?
In one of the West Africa states.
Ewo, ebi memu wa memba ko.
Madam, in my vision, I saw.
Ma biye, ma di somi wuye.
That there's going to be a lot of attacks on you.
And put some baby the mouth.
Verbal attacks.
As anumu and put some swa.
Spiritual attacks.
Susu be put some swa.
In the coming months. But madam, the Lord said I should tell you. It will end in praise. I saw you and your boss forming the next government in Umofia. In the realm of the spirit. I saw that this female
running mate
was wearing a long gown. I don't know whether he's a professor, he's a doctor, he's a nurse. I don't know.
Nurse, doctor, not professor,
but I saw that he was a female running. The Lord said, I should tell her. There's going to be an attack on you.
And push it to the
don't step down. Don't throw in the towel.
No,
I see you and your boss.
Mm-hmm.
As a major prophet of God. Forming the next government in Umofia.
Oh,
I Let's pray for South Africa.
South Africa.
Let's pray for the monarch of England.
England.
The Lord carried my spirit. And I got to Buckingham Palace. And I saw that there were a lot of flowers. And I saw that great England was crying. Let's pray for the Queen. The Lord said, I should tell the business community. The Lord took me to a deeper sleep. And I saw that the leaves were dry. I saw that the leaves of the business community were withered. I saw that people were businessmen and women were contemplating of leaving the shores of Umofia. I saw that businessmen and women were sent and they were behind and they were before the law. I saw that businessmen and women were folding up their businesses. But the Lord said, you businessman and woman, listen and watching me.
Why you me?
Do not give up. Do not give up. Because help is on the way. The leaves that have been withered, it shall be very, very green very soon. The Lord said, I should tell you, greater majority of you contractors, don't worry, don't kill yourself. The Lord said, a time is coming. He's raising a new system and king. There'll be joy. I saw the leaves coming back again. I saw the milk of the cow that were dry. The milk were full again, and the breasts of cow were feeding the nation. To the business community, better days are coming. The Lord took my spirit, and I saw a church, and I saw that two of their leading people were saying goodbye. Let's pray for this church. This church has been in the system. They have a huge following. And this church, I'm seeing something like I in it. They are going to experience severe crisis. And I saw two of their followers, leading followers, one from the Vin part of Umofia and one from the central western part of Umofia. They wanted to attack them. One was taken before the court. There was so much pain. And one fell and was about to say goodbye. Let the church pray. I saw this vision clearly. So let the church pick it up and pray. But I'll be praying for them at my own level. The next prophecy. Then I'm about to bring the prophecies to an end. I've seen a lot of prophecies, but I will not say all. I have a family to protect. I have a church to protect. I have a future to live. And wisdom demands that I walk in wisdom. The next prophecy. I saw a minister of energy in Umofia. I saw that in my vision. He was carried from a new car. And dropped in a new car.
And he said this car from.
And this car I was seeing was a presidential car.
Come on, now your presidential car.
In the land and nation of Umofia.
I was saying, Umofia.
And all that I saw was that. He went and took the back seat of the car. He's a minister of energy. And I saw that another person went to sit in front of the driver's seat. And the one that was sitting in front of the driver's seat tried to ignite the car. But the car was not able to ignite. If the NDC will listen, and they will check the system. The Lord said, I should tell them. They will win. Like they won. In the realm of the spirit. But the system. They should check the system. They should check the CE. And they should check the electronic system. Because I saw that the man that sat at the other The Lord took my spirit into a deep sleep. And I saw the administrative capital of Umofia. The chief government agent there. There was and there was a conspiracy against him. This prophecy will come to pass quickly, so I want to repeat again. The chief administrative capital, the government agents there. Sir, there is a conspiracy against
him.
Your own people. I saw something like town new. I don't know whether you are from town new or something. If you are from town new, if you are from town new, please you check yourself. The lizard that jumped from the high iroko tree said, since men have learned to fly without no missing, it has also learned to fly without, since men have learned to shoot without missing, it has also learned to fly without no missing. Something got in us here. Men and women can't straight. Men can't straight. No, what you answer? Am I communicating?
Yes, Lord.
Nana, may say I'm coming. Am I prophesying?
Yes, sir.
Am I prophesying?
Prophesying.
Praise him the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I saw again in my dream. A lot of people say, let's pray for the sports ministry. I don't know what will happen there. But the Lord said we should pray for the sports ministry. I saw again in my vision a man of God who was very angry. I saw it this dawn. I saw Prophet Usubempa very angry in the spirit. And I saw, and the Lord told me that there's going to be a political disorder in one of the West African states. They have risen again the spirit of God. Let's pray for Mali. Let's pray for Umofia. Let's pray for Cameroon. Praise him the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You see, you are confused.
My God.
I am prophesying. Can you give it to Jesus?
Yes, Lord.
Again, I am seeing a disorder in Guinea. Let's pray for Guinea. I see another mad man. Let's pray for Guinea. The Lord carried my spirit to a place called Uganda. And I saw in Uganda, the special prosecutor, the second one, who also resigned in Uganda. There was a first prosecutor who resigned. And I'm seeing another special prosecutor who also resigned. Because the system will not help. I saw it in Uganda.
Yes, Lord.
Am I communicating?
Yes, sir.
Am I communicating?
Yes, sir.
The Lord said,
Radicine,
we should pray,
yeah, man, pray
for the nation of Nigeria.
Nigeria, man.
I heard a name like Okola Okola.
Okola Okola.
I don't know whether I'm not a Nigerian, but I entered into the Senate of Nigeria.
Nigeria.
And the Lord said, sir, I should tell you. I don't know respectfully if you are. I heard Okola Okola in Nigeria.
Oh, Nigeria.
Said the Lord said I should tell that Nigeria is waiting for you. But go before God. It is not the next year, next 2 years. Go before God. Said the Senate, I don't know whether you're a Senate president, but the Lord mentioned Okola Okola
something.
You'll be president one day in Nigeria.
And
the Lord said we should pray and tell Atiku that Nigeria is before you. The Lord said he's about to visit you and honor you. Again, I saw in my vision a nation called Umofia, where their capital is called Kampala. I saw that one of their first ladies died. The Lord said we should pray for them. The Lord said, I should tell all of you here that this year is your year of growth. And the Lord said, anybody that will walk in the tenets of the Lord, the Lord said he will bring you growth by every side. Am I communicating? The Lord bless you. Somebody will say that, oh, this prophet, they are scared. No prophet is scared. Are you here with me? We have a repressive system. The repressive system.
That system is still personal.
There is somebody who say that, oh, they have come after the prophetic.
We
are so happy. President Mills didn't come after the prophetic. President Muhammad didn't come after the prophetic. President Kufuor didn't come after the prophetic. I'm now in Ghana. In Ghana, the system today is very repressive.
System now,
whereby they are silencing and ganging every critical voice. And we are just praying and we keep on praying for Ghana. That the Lord will show Ghana mercies. And if you are happy that they are ganging the prophetic or the church,
when you are
all of us will not rise up and speak against it, maybe you might be next. This year prophecy, those who are deep will understand it. I'm not the one to make somebody popular. I'm not the one to make somebody who wants to be popular, me. But one thing that I will say is that Zechariah 2 verse 8, he said, I have called my men in my glory. And anybody that touches my men, I the Lord, he has touched my eyes. Any state institution, any man, and it's because they are doing it because of the agenda of 2024, what they want to do. The Lord revealed and the Lord showed me. Now I've left the nation and the people of Ghana. I am in Togo. And the Lord said, because of what they want to do during 2024, they want to silence the voice of prophets. But they know that 2024, the election will be determined by the words and the utterances and the decree of the prophets. But hear me well. The Lord puts me to a deep sleep. And the Lord carried me into the realm of the spirit. And the Lord said, no deputy president will be president. No deputy president will be president. In the nation of Umofia, giving the benefit of 12 years from now. My last prophecy. The Lord said, I should tell John Mahama. He should take care of himself. Take very good care of himself. Well, he will form the next government of in the Republic of Ghana. All that he needs is to take very good care of himself. Very, very good care of himself. Mr. Former President, the Lord says, don't depart from his ways. And everybody who is being repressed by the systems today of today, be assured by Nebuchadnezzar will go. Be assured, I am talking as a prophet of God. The hands of Pharaoh shall be broken by fire. Are you here with me? When they are confused, and when they are not doing and they've missed their way, then they'll send their dog to come and attack men of God, to come and attack the church. You, that dog, we have buried you in the spirit. Spiritually and physically, we are buried
you.
And God will deal with you. But whoever touches a prophet has touched the eye of God. And you will go down. You have not seen anything. You go down. Praise Him, the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Anybody that touches and come after the church this year, the Lord said, I should tell you that heaven will come after you. So may the Lord bless you.
Amen.
May the Lord keep you.
Amen.
May the Lord cause His face to shine on you.
Amen.
May every evil agenda concerning your life,
Amen.
May it be broken by fire.
Amen.
I bless your head.
Yes, I receive it.
I bless your feet.
I receive it.
I bless your hands.
I receive it.
May you live long.
Amen.
May you live long.
Amen.
May you live long.
Amen.
To witness.
Amen.
A better government to come.
Amen.
A better system to come.
Amen.
Shout a better amen.
Amen. Amen.
Prophecy for the year 2022. I am done.
Amen.